This video will show you how to fill out the update registration form. Use this form if you are a registered facility and possess an FAC registration number. You can change facility information such as facility name, DBA name if the owner is still the same, as well as update address, phone number, machine adds, machine removals, and machine information for correction and room updates. Be sure to have all machine information available and your facility registration number to aid you in completing this form. Please do not use this form for ownership changes. In order to access our homepage, please go to cdph.ca.gov/RHB. Once you are at the homepage, select X-ray Machine Registration and Compliance, and you will be taken to the page shown here. Select the link next to the yellow arrow to access the forms portal. Please note that Internet Explorer does not work with this portal. You can also access the registration portal by directly entering https://cdph-rhb.powerpportals.us/. Once you reach the registration portal, you will see that there are four options to choose from. We are going over update registration in this tutorial. Select the link where the yellow arrow is pointed. Section 1 is facility information. Please complete all required boxes for your facility and facility contact information. Register information, registration FAC number, address, etc. If you are updating your mailing and/or physical address, you enter the old address first on the left side, then click on the update dot and enter the new address on the right side. Again, please do not use this form for ownership changes. When you are done completing the applicable boxes, select the Next button at the bottom of the page. Section 2 is Add Machines. Here, you individually fill in the information for all the machines you are adding to your inventory. As mentioned earlier, you will need all your machine information, including manufacturer, model, date acquired, room, and number of X-ray tubes. Select the Add Machine button on the right. If you do not have machines to add, select Next. A pop-up window will appear. Fill in all the information for the machine. Please note that if you have purchased a previously owned machine and you are including it in your registration, the date acquired is the day that you took possession of said machine. When you get to the type code section, select the drop-down. The drop-down menu appears with various type codes listed. Review the type code category and select the description that best describes the machine you are registering. You will then click on the magnifying glass lookup icon to the right and select the type code that best matches the intended use of the machine. Once you have completed all the information, select the Create button. All machines you have entered are compiled into a list as you see on this screen. Select Add Machine if you have additional machines, or if you are finished with adding machines, select Next. Section 3 is Remove Machines. Here is where you fill in information for machines you are no longer in possession of, or that have been made incapable of producing radiation. Incapable of producing radiation means a radiation machine is no longer functional. Unplugging a machine or placing a functional machine in storage for use at a later time is not considered incapable of producing radiation. For this section, you will need all your machine information: manufacturer, model, removal date, and room name. Select the Remove Machine button to enter removed machine information. Please note, if the information provided does not match state records, it will prevent the processing of the removal. If you do not have machines to remove, select Next. Fill in the machine information for the machine you want removed. The removal date is the date the machine was made incapable of producing radiation, sold, or disposed of. When complete, select the Submit button. Section 4 is Update Machines. Use this section to correct information of a machine that is currently registered, such as a typo in the manufacturer or model, update room information, change the type code, or update X-ray tube count. Do not use this section for machine replacements. Machine replacements are reported via the Add and Remove sections. Select the Update Machine Info button to enter corrected information. If you do not have any updates, select Next. If you have machines that need to be updated, fill in the current machine information on the left and then the corrected machine information on the right. Reminder, do not use this section for machine replacements. Select Submit when complete. Section 5 is Review. Once you have completed the information in sections 2, 3, and/or 4, be sure to review this entire page to ensure that you have entered everything correctly. Once you have reviewed the information, select the Next button at the bottom of the page. Section 6 is Sign and Submit. This is the final section on the form. Please fill in your full name and title, then sign the form using your mouse. When you are finished, select the Submit button. You will then be taken to the Submission Confirmation page. You have the option of creating a copy of this page by selecting the Print button in the top right corner. Please make note of your tracking ID number. This number will be needed for reference if you have any questions about the status of your submission. Our contact information is at the end of this tutorial. Thank you.